Previously on Naughty Guys.
Alrighty, it's time for the sh** talk. That's absolutely insane. It takes 1 hour to take poop water and turn it into
clean water.
Clean water. It makes basically chlorine out of salt water.
Correct.
By itself.
By itself.
My mind is kind of blown. We are at the Headhunter headquarters, and the reason we brought you here is because it's a really important part of our build.
By flushing the pantyhose in the quarters, we're showing there's no moving parts inside the toilet. This means there's nothing to break on the discharge side, so no one ever has to get dirty.
Yuck. That is gross.
So Paul, your dad started this company.
Yes, 1981. Started out as just a marine plumbing service company.
So your dad saw the problems that people were facing.
And they had the idea of, let's make our own system that's different and unique.
So where are we?
So this is the area where the treatment systems start being made. They all get assembled and then tested here.
How do they get tested? That's our logo.
Yeah, we're cutting.
Oh, look at this.
The black water and the gray water. What happens to it when you really are cruising?
This is a welding department. And our treatment systems are put together here. This is your size treatment plant.
Oh, really?
If somebody flushes something through the toilet, but it's not supposed to go in there, is there a strainer somewhere?
Yes, I'll show you.
All of these panels and like all these components, you
all
guys
made in house?
Yes.
Put this all together in house.
All right, you're gonna be famous on TV.
Hi.
Where do we go from here?
Testing, I like that.
Testing.
Go to testing.
Are there regulations you guys have to follow? Like, how does it work?
Very strict regulations. Oh.
What's been the craziest thing that you've heard people flush down the toilet? So you guys also make water bottles?
Yes.
So we have that as well.
What do we have? I don't know. You did the list.
You have the Aquabox.
This is on you.
I don't have the list though, but I know already we peeked ahead and we actually have exactly the same
setup. You have this twin Aquabox set.
Built-in dry run protection. They're variable speed, constant pressure. They're multi-stage pumps, so they have a pretty flat curve. They deliver a lot of water at pressure. A real compact package.
Pretty good diameter piping actually, right?
Yeah, you're going to want at least 1.25 inch piping coming out of this thing.
Case, what did you call them?
I wanted to call them the Stormtrooper pumps.
I think they look like it. For all the Star Wars fans out there, put it in the comments. What do you guys think?
And then we got the little Stormtrooper over there.
Yeah, that's the Aquabox Mini, yep.
A Mini, exactly, right there.
So is that the biggest freshwater pump you're selling?
That's, as far as capacity, this is the biggest one. We have some other ones, more industrial, for like special projects, but these are
But in the yachting world, that will be it.
The Mach 5 has been around for over 20 years. It's a little bit less capacity, but it's another bulletproof, you know, very reliable pump system, standard on your Vikings. It was popular on the Hatteras's.
And that goes more like into the super yacht
area already? Yeah. A lot of the super yachts, they're really tall and they want to be able to wash the boat up high, so they lose a lot of pressure to get up there.
Yeah.
Are you telling me we have a super yacht pump
somewhere? No, we just happen to have a tall boat.
Yeah.
No, but usually,
you got to run all those toilets.
I remember, like back in the days. True. I mean, you know, I grew up metric, so I don't know, it was PSI, but I know that a meter is roughly one bar in pressure. So that's, if you just go up, you know, 10 meters, it's 10 bar. That's a lot of pressure you got to produce in order even to get the water up there.
Okay, what else?
12 or 24 volt pump, our DC pump that we developed.
Wait, this whole thing is working? I thought this was just a display.
No.
Well, look at that.
We bring this to the Fort Lauderdale show. We run all our pumps because some people might be interested in the Stingray. Some people might
so
be interested in the Aquabox.
So it's all hooked up and you
Aquabox,
can turn it all on. Wow. What, you could feel it?
Oh my God, it's so quiet.
So that's a DC variable speed pump.
So would that be a pump that's running a shower?
Correct. That's what we have.
It's running, right now it's running two. And
this one pump is running
We can simulate a flush as well. One of these came on.
And it's amazing.
You run in.
So wait, just run the shower. Can it just run the shower? Well, that is so quiet.
Are you kidding me?
That is so quiet. I'm just comparing it to, we've been in a lot of different boats, Rico and I.
And if I would have known this before, honestly, like even for our boat, when ours gave in, instead of replacing it with beep, if I would have known this product, I would have bought this immediately.
It's so quiet.
This is incredible.
Yeah,
now imagine this under the floorboard, you wouldn't hear anything anymore.
It's definitely a pet peeve of mine, a lot of sailboats and quite a few of the catamarans, that the pumps are just so
loud.
And this is pretty incredible for, you know, for how quiet it is. To me, that's comfort. And, you know, besides it being efficient and it has to be able to operate, it's got to be quiet. That's when you feel like you're in a house on the water versus a boat. So
that's when people are saying like, oh, it feels like camping.
Yeah, exactly. They're like when the pumps are just, you wake up the whole boat when your pumps are going, you flush and the whole boat's up.
Yeah, some of the, especially DC pumps or, you know, old style, conventional DC, they're very noisy or they're controlled by a mechanical pressure switch. So it's like,
instead
of like a variable speed or something.
You get a positive displacement pump and it's like
exactly. This is pretty impressive. I know if you're not a boater, you probably don't get it, but if you're an RVer, you totally get it.
Oh, 100%.
It's just so loud.
So since we're already here, like, these are some of the ways to display the tank
levels. These are our fluid level tank level monitoring system. Our tank sentry system, and we're basically measuring the hydrostatic pressure inside a tube in your tank, and that gives us a voltage signal that sends to the panel, or if you have your own touchscreen, you can buy the sender and you can use that to monitor your own tanks.
So it's not a floaty, it's literally just the pressure.
There's no moving parts inside the tank. There's nothing electrical inside the tank.
So less maintenance, less problems.
Right.
It'll automatically purge itself over time if the pressure changes.
Hmm. Very cool. Let's go check out the pump department.
Keep a lot of inventory, so we don't want to run out.
This just keeps on going. How big is this building?
50,000 square feet.
But having everything in one location, whole central, you guys get to keep your quality control. You have your eye on everything. It's the way to do it.
The test you're doing here right now is an endurance test?
Yeah, well, it's like a life cycle test. We do a lot of different tests. And this one is a test where we keep it under pressure for over 2 hours to make sure nothing's leaking.
Oh, got it. Just to make sure. And that, you can do that with every pump?
We're doing it 100%.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's quality control.
That's time consuming.
Yes. Yeah.
So I'm guessing you don't have too many warranty cases coming to you when they're just installed.
Well, when you're developing products, things come up and you got to figure out what's happening. And so,
testing every single pump.
The goal is to not let it leave the building.
How
long is the warranty on the pumps?
That's a 2-year warranty.
2-year warranty.
Yep.
And then some of the other equipment?
5-year on the treatment systems, 5-year on the toilets.
That's pretty good.
That's a pretty very generous good warranty. Yeah. 5 years.
5 years is a long time.
Where are we?
We are in the electronics department. This is where we put together all the tank sentry. This is our tank sentry. These all get made in here.
Wow. It all gets put together here.
It all gets
you
put
don't
together
just
here.
Buy this component from somewhere?
We get some of the electronic components that you can't get in America. We'll buy, but everything gets assembled here. The control boards get assembled here. There's a pick and place machine that puts them all together, and then they finish it off soldering here.
Pick and then, place machine. I got to see that.
We'll show you that, and then we test them all before they go out.
So if something is really wrong, you know, with it, and if someone's using it, you guys have a really good handle on, because it's been put together in-house by your own peeps. So it's pretty easy to figure out.
Yeah, and if there is something wrong,
we
pride ourselves on helping find what's wrong for the customer and then solving the problem.
Also probably makes it easy if there is really an issue. You can probably send the faulty unit back and just get a replacement, or how would that work?
A real person answers the phone with RI, real intelligence. And processes the claim.
I love that. I mean, isn't that one of the most frustrating things in times now? Like anywhere you're calling and you're talking.
It's not a real person.
You're spending 10 minutes already even before you get to anywhere.
It takes a few minutes to figure out if they're real. That's just even scarier now. Like,
It gets better and better in terms of sounding like real.
But eventually they tap out because they're not real intelligence, and then you're just stuck.
You're going to talk to a real person, deal with one of our sales engineers who are either an engineer or they've done this forever. They've been in service and they've moved up and they know what's going on.
I just want to see what you're doing.
Huh? Go ahead.
That is so small.
Yeah.
You don't even use like a magnifying glass or anything.
Yeah. She's doing it every day.
Wow.
She's a real pro.
This is what happens at this stage of the production. The electronics get potted in a protective special epoxy.
Completely
sealed. So this is like a switch for a toilet, time delay switch.
And you can adjust the timing of things?
Yeah, you can adjust some of the programming for the valves, how long it flushes for.
How much water you use, et cetera.
Exactly. Yep.
So you also do that in-house?
Yep.
I gotta say, I did not know that you guys are so...
vertically integrated?
Yes.
Yep.
I gotta say, I'm really impressed.
Here's a control board with parts put on it. The pick and place machine takes these little tiny parts and goes through the whole process of attaching them to the board.
You put the empty green board in there.
Yes.
And then it comes out like this.
These get put on. This one was started.
Wow.
Yeah, you can see what it looks like before. Mm-hmm.
This is before and then as it starts putting on them.
So what's the difference between like what they're doing by hand and the machine?
Yeah, it's a good question. So what she's doing is called through-hole mount. Back in the old days, all the electronic components, your resistors, capacitors, everything, had little pins, you know, wires sticking out, and you had to bend it and stick it through the board.
Yes.
Somebody had to come in and solder it. Very labor, time-consuming, and then, you know, the new technology is a lot of the logic controllers are little chips, and they're surface mount. They're smaller, so they just get kind of glued in place. And it's all done by a machine. So that eliminates about 95% of the through-hole mount. Sorry, you still need to do some through-hole mount, you know, to mount your power wires and pump control wires and things. So, you know, this machine has allowed us to produce a lot more with the same number of people.
Yeah.
And has actually improved the quality because it's very repeatable
what it does.
It's a robot, you know.
Yeah.
But also requiring a substantial investment because I know these machines are not cheap.
No, they're not cheap. And somebody's got to program them, set them up.
Yeah.
And you still got to maintain them.
The advantage for us, too, is also the you know, a capacitor that used to be like this big is now like this big.
Exactly.
You
know,
everything just gets shrinks down and gets smaller, and it generates less heat, and, you know, it just kind of multiplies.
That makes sense. All right, where are we going next? Anyway, the guys are like, I don't know, what is interesting to you guys? We're like, it's all interesting. Everything is interesting. Shipping is interesting. Show us everything. So we were just here, like, 20 minutes ago when we decided how we're going to film this for you guys. And this was hustling, bustling. This was busy. Yep. Now we're towards the end of Friday.
End of the day on Friday.
Yeah, it's slowing down. But this is one busy department here.
Right.
So everything goes out here.
Yeah. So like you see, that's equipment going to Taiwan, Ocean Alexander.
Oh, okay.
Right
there.
They're going to Viking, San Diego Marine Exchange.
San Diego Marine, Viking.
This is to an RV builder,
Featherlight. Oh, that's RV, huh?
RV.
Bro Brothers.
There's a big one back there.
These guys are in Louisiana. Build
there's a big one back there, Choi Lee. There was a Choi Lee one over there.
Okay, Choi Lee order. So our order came from here, and now we're going to see it in Turkey.
Did you guys wrap ours kind of special with like
a bow?
Some really nice paper
We put lots of free t-shirts and... chocolate bars.
Yes.
Chocolate bars.
Yeah. They're melted by now.
Teddy bears.
But don't worry, you can flush them.
So a lot of times with a big builder, they order a big system from us, the toilets, the water pressure sets, treatment systems. Well, not everything flows through the shop and gets here at the same exact time. So we might have one part of the order comes ahead of the other. This other room back here is like our staging room. It allows us to kind of store things until everything
ready.
Else catches up. So these guys are that work here, they're kind of like pulling together the whole complete package, getting it ready to go. Sometimes we're loading a container.
Got it.
Sometimes the customer's providing their own freight company. The logistics of shipping internationally, that's a lot of work.
I cannot imagine. Yeah.
And then packaging is important too, because you want the stuff to get there and not be broken. Before we moved here, we were in another building not far from here. It was much smaller.
Yeah.
And to do this shipping and receiving thing, we would come here in the morning and have to use the forklifts, take everything out, and we were using the parking lot as our staging area and kind of move everything around.
That's hard.
And at the end of the day, you put it all back inside.
This is working a lot better,
we're able to spread out and kind of have a little bit more control to the chaos.
Are you guys still good in this space, or are you already eyeballing for more
You're
space?
Always looking. You know, we're good for now.
Yeah.
It's working for now. Where haven't we gone yet?
Kyle, you don't want to be on the YouTube video?
Nope.
Come on, man.
Such a hard no. Wow. Yeah. A little bit hurt.
Yeah, man.
What's his position?
Engineer.
We should definitely have him on. We should definitely have him on the video.
As long as you don't film him, you can film his desk, which is...
You can film his desk.
No, really, it's impressive.
Just wore my face out, okay?
Yeah. Whoa. Look at this. It's a typical engineer's desk here.
Whoa!
That is Incredible.
Dangerous by design.
Dangerous by design.
Kyle designed all the electronic controls for the sewage treatment system. So the system you're getting, the control panel, is designed by him.
Very cool.
The person whose face you guys will not see.
No, he wants to remain anonymous.
Yeah. And then, you know, we have our chlorine generators.
Power supply, auto-chlor power supplies.
Yeah. Even this little fan.
It gets hot.
Why you don't want to be on camera? You've got OnlyFans or what's going on?
he doesn't want to be on the internet because it's out there forever.
I agree.
I respect
that. I understand.
Oh, that's cool. So that's what the shipyard is always asking for. 3D models, all the drawings, so they know exactly how much space things need.
And then we take something like this, and then, you know, we make a drawing like this for the guys to build.
For the production.
Yeah, for production.
Mm-hmm. So you have a lot of work on your hands.
Yeah, we torture Mikhail, like some special projects. The chief engineers want something custom and changed, and they want the door to swing a certain way on the panel.
Those damn super yachts.
Yeah. Demanding customers. You know, that's a chlorine generator.
You turn the lid off the box.
So you get the salt water in and then discharge?
Salt water comes in here. This solenoid valve controls the flow through the cell. This is where it cooks the seawater into chlorine, and then it discharges out here. Into the treatment plant.
And then you also have discharge back out with the leftover salt water, or is it just...
That's the service drain at the bottom there. Mm-hmm. But like, since this system requires pressurized seawater to run, we just tap off of that to get to as a source of seawater.
Oh, got it. Piping diagram?
Piping diagrams, you know, wiring diagrams.
Yeah. So you create these?
Diagrams. Yes. Well, I get a sales order, and then I turn it into build sheets.
Yeah.
And then I turn the build sheets into production drawings, and I put the production drawings out and actually get done.
The process is, you know, salesman sells the unit, brings the sales order in to Mikhail, and, you know, we try to lock down exactly what the specifications are for that device, because we do some customization. We try to avoid it if we can, standardize it, but on some of the bigger boats, they always want something a little different.
It's pretty hard on yachts, the really big boats.
And so we got to get that all locked down before... We develop the production documentation.
We have control panel drawings that have all the wires and the whole panel, and everything's numbered on both ends. And every single wire in the panel. You probably saw a completed control panel out there. Well, it starts like this, and about a 7 or 8 page drawing that there are assembler then goes through and turns it into reality.
Yeah, that's amazing. Very cool.
Thank you for showing it to us. Is there anything about your guys' company that you feel like people don't know about or what you do? It's like, it's just a simple thing to you, but it's something
I
that
think
you
one of the
people
big,
don't know about you.
Yeah, the biggest things is that we kind of have everything all together in one roof, not just the manufacturing part with all these different product lines, but also the service and installation.
What these guys
do every day, they go out to the boats and troubleshoot and fix and repair or install new systems. We send people all over the world, actually, to do service work. We'll have competitors, like maybe they make a toilet, nothing else. And they don't go out on a boat and do serve.
So you do the whole system.
We do all this stuff. You know, we sell to other installers and suppliers and boat builders, but we also have our own guys that'll go sell to the individual boat owner and put it in. It's a turnkey package.
Which is pretty amazing because that allows you to have a feedback of your own service guys. Not just warranty, but also install all of these different things. Yep. What's working, what's not working.
Right, exactly. So like when we develop a new product, our service team will be the first ones to install it. Before we release it into the general marketplace, and we let it, you know, test it out for a while,
see how
it goes.
Other thing we do, we'll do some custom builds, hot tubs for boats that are being built or boats that are already out there, cold plunges mixed together, and one custom build for boat builders or for a client that already owns a boat. I think our pipe fitters and our welders and our painters, you know, I think they're second to none.
That's all here.
In Fort
Lauderdale.
They'll go to Savannah, they'll go to Miami, and they'll go wherever you need them.
Who is testing out the hot tubs here in the facility? Whose job is that?
It's an open position right now.
I made him.
He just admitted he just went like that.
I'll send you a picture.
It is a janitor's job.
I'll send you a picture. We did a hot tub for a builder in Turkey, Ursa Yachts. I don't know if you ever heard of them.
Yeah.
So we built them a custom hot tub from scratch during COVID. It could either be one big hot tub, or you could put a divider in, make one side cold and one side hot.
That's cool.
Kind of cool, actually.
So, and then we had the owner come in here and test it after we test, made sure everything's okay.
Yeah. So you had like a team building testing on the hot tub.
Yeah, it was cool.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this talk. I got to say, I was excited to have the system on our boat. By knowing you guys' reputation in the industry, it being US company, like it checked up a lot of boxes. But actually, after being here and seeing everything, I'm even more excited. Because
same here.
I didn't know that you guys are that thorough. It makes sense now why your reputation is that good. Yep. But yes, we're super excited to have Headhunter on our yacht.
Thanks for coming out.
Thanks for showing us
around. Absolutely. Yeah.
You guys, if you have any questions, all you tech geeks with all your crazy techie questions, put them down in the comments underneath the video, and we'll see if we can get a little bit of help and see if we can answer them.